What I'm going to talk about today is Knoxville in general. Obviously, you guys, now tell me if I have this right. You guys volunteer your time to help with the Knoxville Chamber and the city of Knoxville. Okay, well, that's one of the reasons why I chose to move back to Knoxville, was because, you know, I played football here. I'm from Portland, Oregon. I came to Tennessee, got drafted, played football for the New York Jets from 2008 to 2010, and then decided that I was done with football. I had a lot of issues that I had faced since I was a little kid, things that as I move into Knoxville and I get more comfortable, I have my second child on the way. It's things that, you know, when you're young, when you're 18 and playing football, when you're 20 and playing football, you don't really think about. You don't think about where you're gonna live when you're done playing football. You don't really worry about your degree. You're just going to class because they make you go to class in order to play football on Saturday. It's one of those, you know, you wish, it's the typical, if I knew then what I know now, how would I have done things? How would I have approached things? And I probably would have done a lot of stuff exactly the same, but a few of the important things I would have done different. Knoxville is unique because, and you guys will all know this even better than I, Knoxville is the biggest small town in America. Everybody knows everybody. Everyone who owns companies knows each other. Everyone helps out with each other. And it's all kind of because of the University of Tennessee and what they do for the community. I had always heard it when I was playing football that when we won games, everyone else made more money. And they kind of, you know, they said that it was kind of a joke, like, hey, make sure you win this week because my hotel will be full or my restaurant will run out of food and stuff like that. And it's a joke, but when you come back and you actually live here, and now that I do what I do, doing radio broadcasting and TV and going around and speaking and stuff, it's true. I mean, we've won two football games and we're playing Florida this weekend and everyone's excited. Everyone can't wait to go to the game, myself included, can't wait to talk about it. Are we gonna win? College game day is coming to Knoxville. That's huge for this town and the football program. But you don't really realize it when you're playing. You know, I was talking to one of my buddies that used to play the other day, and he was going, man, I don't ever remember being this excited to play football games. And I was like, yeah, me either. You know, you're just worried about going to class and then getting home and then going and doing whatever it is what you were going to do. And then by the time you get to the game, you're so ready to play the game. You're not worried about what people are saying on the radio or what they're writing about you or what's going on in the community. You don't care. You're 19. I mean, we all remember being 19. And being a football player and having that responsibility is a lot. The blessing is you're 19 and you don't understand the responsibility that you have. You just go out there and play. It's not until you're done playing that you realize how important Tennessee football really is to this community. I ramble when I talk about that. Excuse me. I ramble when I talk about that because now that I'm not playing football anymore, and now that I have children of my own and another one on the way, and I've chosen to come back to Knoxville and live here, all the stuff that I'd heard in a joking manner the whole time I was in college, I live now. And I see that. I see the dividend. You know, I see how it, you know, blesses my life when the football team does better. You know, I almost hate even saying that I do better when the football team wins, but it's not just true for me, it's true for the entire community. And it's really fun that they're relevant and they're playing good. One of the things that I do want to say to you guys today, you know, that kind of addresses my history with off the field issues that I'd had since I was in middle school. It's players that get kicked off the team. Whether you're a diehard fan or you just read the newspaper or you just listen to the radio or you don't know much at all, most people are aware of the names of the kids that get kicked off the team. Tyrann Mathieu, the Honey Badger, gets kicked off of LSU. For what? For smoking pot. Derrick Rogers gets kicked off Tennessee. For what? Smoking pot. It's an issue, and it's something that's going to continue to get worse. Whenever I go speak and I talk about football and my experience, and I can do this when I'm not on the radio, one of the things I ask people is to just take a step back when stuff like that happens. When you see a kid get kicked off the team, it's easy as a fan, myself included, to look at him and go, oh, what an idiot. Why did he do that? What's he doing? Doesn't he know we need him to win games? And that's the fan that comes out of me when that happens. The realistic person that comes out, the person that sees it as a realist and what's going on, is that person obviously has issues that stemmed way before he ever was a Tennessee Volunteer. It's rare that kids come to campus at any school, especially Tennessee, because we know how we treat those football players. If Tyler Bray was in here right now, he's way cooler than I am. You know, and if I was in here when Casey was done playing, I would have been way cooler than Casey was. And that's how it works, and we treat them like rock stars. And in doing that, we need to also step back a minute when some of them have problems. The reason I asked if you guys were a group of people that volunteer their time is because we have a community of people we're the Tennessee Volunteers. We have a lot of people that are willing to help. And one of the things that I'm trying to do around town through the Knoxville Drug Commission and stuff like that is help some of the kids, football players or not, that have issues, because we have a pretty serious problem. I don't know how many of you are aware of it, but East Tennessee has a pretty significant problem with prescription drug use amongst teenagers and young people. And that's something that needs to be addressed, and I feel like I'm not doing my due diligence if I don't at least bring it up and say that when I'm speaking to someone, if anyone does anything with that, that I'm more than willing to volunteer my time and help and speak and do anything I can to talk to people or kids or help any way I can. You know, I think once you have kids of your own and you stop living for yourself and you start living for other people, you realize how much this stuff is really important. My football career at Tennessee was interesting. I actually said it on the radio today. We have a kicker on our football team who's getting a lot of crap, Michael Pilardi. Everyone that knows anything about football knows that everyone can't stand Pilardi because he misses extra points, and we've been giving him a hard time, and we do it in a joking manner. But what I said on the radio was, hey, if anyone can make fun of the kid, it's me, because I went through a lot of public scrutiny when I was the Tennessee quarterback, because we won 10 games, and then we won 5, and then we won 19 in the 2 years after that. So I know what it's like to walk around town, and just, we're passionate. We like winning, and when we're winning, it's awesome, and when you're losing, it's tough. And one of the things that I brought up today was how passionate our fans are. I had James Wilhoit on, who used to be our kicker, who made the field goal that beat Florida the last time we beat them. And just talking to him and getting his experience, and talking to Coach Fulmer on the phone, and we're gonna have Johnny Majors out to our tailgate this Saturday at Roost Chris. And Tennessee football, man, it means so much to so many people. You don't realize it when you're playing, and you kind of start to realize, I'm 26, so although I like to think I'm distinguished and older and wise, I'm still young and kind of a punk, and so I get that, and so it's good for me to get around these people like Coach Majors and Coach Fulmer, and I talk to Coach Sanders and Cut on the phone all the time, and just listening, I think I know a lot until I talk to those guys and realize, it makes me like 18 again, sitting in there with wide eyes, my tail wagging, not having a clue what's going on. And it's good to talk to those kind of people and get a perspective on what Tennessee football really means to the community. I don't know if you guys have any questions for me. I just kind of wanted to come in here and talk a little bit about why I chose to live in Knoxville, which is because it's such a great place to raise a family. I've lived in some great and not so great parts of the country and parts of the town, and Knoxville's great. There's parts that are obviously that are better than others, but Knoxville in general is great. The surrounding county, Blount County's awesome. I love going to Sevierville, Gatlinburg, Pigeon Forge. I'm actually going bear hunting in a month. I don't know how that's going to turn out, but I'm going bear hunting in the Smokies. So it's stuff like that that makes this community and the surrounding counties around it so special. And I'm just glad to be a part of it. I'm glad that I'm here and that you guys want me to come speak. I think that's cool. It's a lot cooler to me now than it would have been when I was 22 years old and been like, oh hell, I got to go speak to the chamber. You know, and I would have. I'd have said it, and I'd have smiled in here and shook all your hands and said, rock and roll, you guys are awesome. And then I couldn't wait to get to my car and leave. And at, you know, just a few years later, it's a lot more special for me to come in and talk to people because I know that people appreciate my perspective. And one of the best things about Knoxville, and I'll end with this, and then if anyone has questions, that's fine. The best thing about Knoxville is it's good Southern people who appreciate nothing more than a second chance. People in Knoxville are very willing to forgive, forget, give second chances. It's not if you make mistakes, it's what you do with the opportunities that you're given afterwards. And one of the things that I've been very surprised about Knoxville is everyone is very, you know, open-armed and excited about what I've been able to do in my life and what we're doing with the radio and all the fun stuff we're doing. So, thank you.